This is Jackpot, Nevada, October the 22nd, 1988. Clay Petzold, one of the honorees today, now celebrating with Arletta their 50th wedding anniversary. The wedding party and guests are staying at Cactus Pete's. Just south of Twin Falls.
Give me a kiss.
Gotta go hunting there for a little bit. Don't even act like you see
the... I'll run around and kiss everyone. I like to do that.
Not so newlyweds. Isn't it remarkable?
Sure.
All right.
Wed 50 years.
There.
And this is this suite where it's all about to take place tonight.
Well, George is talking in it right now.
You forgot to kiss Wanda.
Oh, God. She can
do it.
I kiss her.
That's Wanda. Arletta's sister.
We go to Twin Falls.
Yeah. She even...
But George is never in the movies. I hate that.
Somebody. Who are these people here?
You go take the pictures.
This is Karen and Ron. There's old Lester sitting over there. Okay, I think I can let you go and get your meal now.
You can go eat now, Arlen. All right, good. I'm starved.
Too much there. You're with your wife for 50 years.
Continuing the party here.
I've been trying to shack up with George
for the 50th wedding anniversary.
My room.
Yeah, we come up here and Arletta had a room for us. We got here, we didn't.
What room is?
Back around the corner here.
And her husband.
I wonder if it,
yeah, they've been down there, and so we just.
Jay.
Turn around, Mark.
Turn around and say something.
I'm Dan. I'm Karen. I'm Ron. I'm Dan.
I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I'm Dan. I
Diane? Diana? I guess she won't look at me.
Yeah. Sister here is going to say a few things, of which you will. So we're going to do that right now. And you guys are going to be really impressed, because I can still walk. Are we ready?
Watch out.
Never mind. I got to do this twice. I knew this. All right, here we go. It's kind of like Miss America. We didn't have this plan.
You didn't.
No, hold it steady.
Oh, you did that just right. Whoa.
Whoa. Is that what she said? All right. There you go. All right. Now, we'll come back over here. You guys talk. And I want to hear you say something nice.
What are you going to say?
Well, I wrote it on my card.
Give her a kiss. Give her a kiss. Kisses.
Everybody for being here. I didn't realize that I had so many friends, Arletta's relatives, and Arletta's and my friends, thank you very much for being here.
And especially the best manager.
Who's that?
She's always telling him what to do. It's always been the same.
Well,
working right out. Why don't you say it then? Mm-hmm.
You embarrassed him.
It's about time. He's embarrassed me a lot.
I didn't mean that.
Can everybody hear on this? I put this microphone on for your benefit because I realize most of Mom's friends are over age. I want you to know that I got my kids here this morning. We all went in, and that's why we were a little late to have our picture taken. And the
she only
man,
gets them once a week.
Yeah, once a week. No, not all of them together. But the man who was taking the pictures was having a difficult time, and that's why he was late getting a picture of this little boy. Couldn't get him to laugh or smile. So he walked out. He doesn't know me from anybody. And he said, come on in here. He said, grandmas can always make kids smile. Yeah, you're right. Okay, I'll come in and do my little grandma thing. But that has nothing to do with what I'm going to talk about. I want Billy, before I thank all of you for coming, and by the way, I was nominated to do this because I'm the oldest.
And the smartest.
And, well, we'll get to that later. But I want...
Can I have another drink?
Me too.
Who are you?
I want First of all, I think I'm going to start out a little bit here, and Billy's going to talk too. I'd like to welcome all of you, and I'm going to kind of try to remember who everybody is and point out so that you won't wonder who that woman is over there sitting there. And most of you know everybody, but a lot of you don't, right? Okay. We'll start over here. Now, should we? You wanted to do some of them.
No, I don't.
Okay. Richard, my cousin Richard, is the bartender. We all give him a big hand. Yay. And the lady on my left is Diana, and she's Billy's better half. And Helen is my cousin Richard, Richard's other better half. And Penny in the front, raise your hand, Penny, is George and Trix Wolf's daughter, if you don't know. And the lady on her right is Mary, who's a childhood friend of Cheryl and also Penny's and went to school in Homedale. And then back in the corner is Les Carter, who's also my mom and dad's best friend from where else? Russ and Phyllis Sayers, who are also older friends of my mom and dad. Newer friends of my mom and dad are Shelley and Dave Shank, Russ and Phyllis's daughter. Now we're over here, let's see, there's Christy, my sweet little niece, Billy's daughter, and her boyfriend, Joe? No?
Joe.
Yeah. Vince. Vince, I haven't met yet. I'm sorry, I haven't been around. He carried up on, yeah.
Come on, Vince, nobody's met you. Jeez.
You're on
a
camera.
This is Vince. What do you think, you guys? Now, I want you to know this guy's got taste.
Come on, it's the boyfriend. Come on.
Oh, that's right.
This week, you
see. Yeah.
This is a classy guy. You noticed what he expected of us. He went out and purchased this just for our event. I am really impressed.
That's true.
Not many people bring a can of beer with them. All right, right behind them are one of my dearest, dearest people in the whole world. My father-in-law, Larry Colton. Larry, you want to stand up so everybody can see you? And my mother-in-law, Virgie. And you can stand up too, sweetie. She's so pretty. And this is my other, my real good half. That's my husband, Ned. Okay.
This is my
Colton.
Oh, look.
I don't have to go. Okay.
Now.
Hmm? No, everybody knows Cheryl. Stand up.
Cheryl.
This is Cheryl.
Hey.
Now we're going to Jim paid me to do that.
That's right.
Okay. Next, we have some friends of mine, of Daddy when he was younger, and Jay Newman, isn't that right? Jay Newman is Clyde Newman's brother, and this is his wife, oh, Elaine? Pardon?
Jean.
I don't know why that, anyway, Jean and Jay, that ought to be easy, right? Okay, and next to Jay, who's Clyde's brother, is Troy.
I gotta tell you something about him. He's done my daddy a lot. And daddy run into a hanger.
I'll walk.
He taught my dad how to fly without drugs, and that's hard to do now.
Yeah, I do.
No good.
But I didn't know my direction.
That's right.
Wait a minute. Not yes. Jay. Clell's the one that...
Clell, right. That's who he was pointing to. Clell is the one.
Sorry.
Clell is the... good guy, right? Okay, right in back of him is Clyde Newman, who's my ever-loving sweetheart. And Clyde has been around since time began, right, Daddy?
Yes.
From the very beginning with my dad. And I want you guys to know that if you have not seen my mother and father's personal picture book, there is a picture of Clyde Newman in there that will turn anybody on. Clyde Newman, at the family, in the tender age of 20 years old, planted pecans, and it was that day. So Clyde Newman took off all his clothes and picked up a rock to hide the parts that he didn't want to have taken in the picture. And I want you to know that rock wasn't a rock, it was a boulder. He was pretty proud that it had to be a boulder.
All right, what a compliment!
Clyde's other half is Francie. Francie's a sweetheart, and I've got a little story about them a little later, too.
Yeah, but she's a pretty one.
And behind Francie is a gentleman that I haven't met yet, but Ruth Gross and first name?
Hank.
Hank and Ruth Gross, who are Mom and Dad's real good friends. And I'll let you, Billy talk about them.
Yeah, they ride around in a big bus. Like Will and Jennings or something. They got a telephone and the television and the whole thing. They just come up and just move in. I don't even think they were invited.
I thought too. I was standing here over here. All of a sudden, I looked down. There's this little lady with pretty gray hair getting food. And I said, "Where'd you come from? Who are you? Did you just walk by and see what was going on? Come in for food?" I figured that's how it happened. You got here. The lady sitting at the table by Francie's name is Blanche. And if you'll look at her pretty big brown eyes, you'll know why she was my father's first girlfriend.
Yeah.
He was crazy about that for a long time.
Wait a minute. Did you want to come up here and tell us a story about swimming in the coulee? Never mind.
For those of you who are out of town or big town people from Chicago, the coulee is not the neighborhood Chinese man. It's... don't know what coolie is. You realize if you get beyond the border of jackpot, people don't know what a jockey box is. They don't know what a coolie is. You have to tell them. It's, you know, this is a different world here.
What is a coolie?
A coolie is a big irrigation ditch that runs behind the 30 acres in Twin Falls, and they used to go down there and have a good time.
About 2 foot wide and about a foot deep.
The coolie.
Kind of like a what?
Okay. My children are always here.
Go ahead,
get running. I never did say that was the same. Okay, now here in the back are Blaine and, please forgive me, Bev. Blaine and Bev. That goes together. Jay and Jean, Blaine and Bev. It's too easy. And Blaine worked with my dad for years and years and years as a carpenter. And you, of course, know my mom and dad, and you know Karen and Ron. Contractor.
No. He's not even there.
Plumber.
Brooklyn.
I don't know. He's got a hand with hand put a house together.
He's not even in a boat.
I'll take it over here. Boy, you screwed that one up. I'll tell you what. This guy over here. They used to call him, you know what they used to call him? You know what his nickname is? Rooster. Oh, the old silver devil. They did. They used to call him Rooster. Bev met him one day, and you know what? Never mind. They moved right to the farm and added on a lot of rooms. Isn't that right? How many rooms you got now?
Lots.
How many kids you got now?
Eight.
Oh. Finally stopped?
Yeah.
I know it. It's hell, isn't it? I could tell a lot of stories, but I'm not going to. I'll shame them on that.
I can tell some of you.
No. I'm up here. You're down there. The next one's, I'm going to let her introduce. I can't remember their name. Were they invited? But Bob, I'll tell you what, I like his tie. Where'd you get that, a yard sale? Good. I'd have sold it too. But I'll tell you what, your coat matches your tie, so you're all right.
Thanks.
Pardon me? Oh, now I need something from you over there, huh? Well, you know, I thought I was drinking B.O., and I think I'm drinking water. Okay, you ready? Your turn. I told you I'd kind of...
Short turn. Okay.
Oh, well, rest a little bit. Let's talk about somebody else. Look at this little guy right here.
Oh.
Yeah. He went in the barbershop one side, but didn't come back. Oh, hi there. Oh, boy. Well, now I hate that. Oh, let's see. Who can we pick on?
Some hair.
Oh, show you a lady with a camera right here. I want to ask her what she did last night. What?
I went to bed early.
Early?
She thought
we left late. And you were still there. How did you go to bed early?
I went home right after.
How much was left in the bottle of vodka that you were drinking? I'll bet you Helen can tell us. Helen, how much was left? Uh-huh. Look at that. Uh-huh. And you made it home? I doubt it. No, she was funny last night. She really was. She really was. And then the couple next to them. They're longtime friends of ours. Well, no, I think you're relatives, aren't you? I knew that. I was just testing. You know, see. But really, no, they're in the horse business. Well, one of them's in the horse business, and one of them's in the trucking, right? Who's in the trucking? Oh, you are. Okay. This is Dale. I said, this is Dale. I pointed to you. My finger's crooked. So, you know, Dad broke it when I was little, you know. Gee whiz. But anyway, yes, Dale's in the horse business. She'll transport horses anywhere you want. She'll buy and sell anything you got. So just give her a call. She'll leave a lot of cars here before she leaves tonight. Dana's in the truck business. He sells, what is it, Mitsubishi? No? No. Oh, I know. It's that nasty word. Peterbilt. No, he repairs. They have a big business up in Seattle, Washington. And they're going great guns right now. Yeah, it'll last about a year. And I'm going to go around, and I'm just hitting them, missing, really. I want this young lady right here to stand up.
That's you. Yeah. My hair isn't as long as yours.
Oh, yeah.
Sure.
Well, I don't know. Wait. Is that your name? Did you change it? Yeah. Wah? This is Tina, and this is Linda's daughter. You couldn't tell it.
Yeah.
No, she's a lot more.
Yes, I have a double chin right here.
Yeah. And you got to work on that. But anyway, she used to model around California. And she went to all these pageants and all these contests and everything else. And what's doing? Is that me?
You can't stand in front of it. You got to move over that way.
Oh, I'll stand behind you.
That better? Over this way?
Again.
That better?
Can't be
it. Oh, shit, I'll go over here and have another drink. Dick? Anyway, no, she used to be a model.
Yeah.
And she, boy, you don't stand in front of that. You can't even.
It's probably
you doing that? Hi there. want to fool around? I knew she would. Because I got the room. No, really. There's a lot of good people here. And I'm not going to. Helen's another one. Helen Petzl, right here. A long time favorite of mine. Lovely lady. She came all the way from Wyoming just to be here tonight. Yes. I think that's very special. There's a lot of good people here.
It's hard to say. Get on with the damn thing.
I'm trying, George. I'm running out of insult. What I'm going to do is turn it back over to her. Oh, sure, you laugh, Penny. Uh-huh. Sitting over there just drunk. Yeah, uh-huh. Your old man's out of town. You're going to have a ball tonight. I'll tell you what. Here she is again. The Val Victorian of Holmdel High School.
Oh,
Linda.
Wow.
Huh?
Okay. I'm going to go back and do what I should have been doing, all right? Back in the corner is my really neat little nephew. No, it's Shannon's husband, and his name is Doug Brown. Shannon, stand up. That's Karen's daughter, Shannon, the sweet one. And they're twins. Did you guys know that? Nobody knew that.
George does.
George knows that. He loved it. Double his money. Remember?
He said, congratulations, George.
Yes. We're getting that. Don't you worry. I want you to know that Lee, stand up. This is Ron's mother, Lee. Now, are we all paying attention? Lee just went to Oklahoma. You know what she did? She snagged a fiancé. So I just want you to know that it's not all over. Just because there's, let's see, now I always get this wrong, don't I? There might not be fire in the smokestack, but there's embers in the timber in the oven. I can't think of it. Getting so mad at me. Hey, there's smoke in the gray in the hair. She made a guest appearance just for us. Holy pardon. Stella Dallas. Weren't you on radio when I was a kid? Once. Okay, the wonderful love story. The man that Lee is marrying was her first husband. 52 years ago. So they're going to be, they really rekindled, right? Okay.
He grew up.
No, I didn't miss Ron and my sister. Didn't I introduce you last time? Everybody knows Ron Crow and my sister Carol, of course. Okay, here's my Aunt Wanda. Aunt Wanda? Okay, Billy wants to say something about Wanda. All right, now I think we're at my cousin Dolores, who's Aunt Laura's daughter, and most of you know that. She's the lady with the Polaroid for us. It's been good to know you. She's a neat piano. If I had known you were going to be here, I would have done without this recording I have. Anyway, next, Dale and Dana.
Don't stand in front of
that. All right, I'm standing in front of my aunt. Dale and Dana are our cousins from Seattle, and they are the representatives of my father's brother's brother, his son and his daughter-in-law, right? Okay. Now we are at my son, Todd. Todd, you want to stand up? Todd doesn't feel too good. He's my sweetheart. He works for Gallo, and I want you to know that every month they give him a case of wine. As, you know, that's part of his job. And so most of the Gallo wine and the champagne that you see here tonight are compliments of my son, Todd. Who had to give up drinking for about a year so that we could have this. I want you to know. And you met him. He could use one, but he had to get three so he could get here and get back on the right time. So we really appreciate him, and we probably spent about... Anyway, it makes me cry. I haven't had them all together for about 5 years. So it seems really nice to have all my kids all in one room all at once.
Wait a minute. Whoa, we're here to have a good time, right, people? Let them ball in the other room. Go ahead. Go outside and go.
Raise
yours, Mom.
Okay. All right. I'm going to start on my left because these two people don't know that I noticed that they moved, but they did move. And they're friends of Jim, who, if you'll remember, about half an hour ago I introduced you as a friend of my sister Cheryl. Okay. Here's Dan and Elaine. The Dan and Elaine show. All right, and back over to my right again. I didn't finish. I kind of got interrupted, didn't I? My Tony is a teacher in Chicago. He teaches inner city kids, and for that he should have a medal all alone. He works day and night. He has a soccer team and a basketball team.
I can't
see. Works as a waiter at Junior.
I can't see.
Can't get it out of his blood. Stand up, Tony. He's my sweetheart.
Okay. I just wanted to say something because being the oldest grand kid, and the first one, and I don't know, I just almost broke down when I saw Grandma and Grandpa kissing. And in this 50th anniversary, I'm so glad I came, and I'm just so happy.
Who's that, Caroline?
All right.
And you met my daughter, Tina. Now, here is the second grandchild, right? Nikki, stand up. This is Nikki. And Nikki is Karen's son. I know all of you thought that was me 10 years ago, but Yeah. We all have these wonderful chins, you'll notice. That's how you can tell who we are, right? Okay. Now.
I don't have one. Well, that's right.
He has an extra Y chromosome.
Extra how long?
A what?
A what? A Y chromosome. I don't know why.
Oh, wait a minute. Let me have it. I want to ask this lady over here. What the hell are you talking about? What's this extra
what?
What?
You know, we all have our little skeleton in the closet.
Never mind.
We're back in here. I want to introduce... I'm trying to think. She's probably the matriarch of our family right now. Is that right, Aunt Violet? The matriarch, Aunt Violet, who's very, very great. She's my father's aunt. She's the mother of my grandfather. And I'm happy to know that I've got all those extra genes that look like that. I don't have any extra Y chromosomes, thank goodness. I didn't get those. Billy got all the extra Y chromosomes. In fact, he is the only one that got a Y. And next to her is my sweet Aunt Helen. I'll tell you the story of how my mother and father met. Okay?
Oh, no.
Oh yes!
Oh, yeah.
Without this story, we wouldn't be here, right? Billy, isn't that right?
Right. I don't know what story he'll tell.
Well, we all know Billy.
I don't know. I guess he has to undress for this. I'm not sure.
Met more than once?
No. They were actually married on October 21st, 1938. You're going to tell about how they met, right?
Silver knife, and I'll bet you he's not right. Come here, Daddy. Oh,
hey.
Todd, give her another wine cooler, would you? Come on, Daddy, come here. Oh, baloney. Arletta. Now, Arletta, I know your nickname was Artella, but come on. Come on. You know, I used to call him CL. I thought he was really, you know, really great. Then I used to call him Chief. Because I thought, man, you know, this guy's done great. He's got a nation here. Now just stand up and walk away from her. Come on. Don't worry. Don't be happy. Don't worry. Right? Come here. No, honest, Mom. I won't take but a minute.
Here we go. There you go.
There you go. Okay. A little bit of sign language.
I'll tell you exactly how I met your mother the first time.
In here.
In here.
Look in there.
No, not in there. I didn't meet her in there.
Come on, Grandpa, turn around.
Turn around.
Faces. We can't look.
I tell you, my real good friend had bought a brand new 38 Chevrolet four-door. We were downtown. Driving back and forth through Twin Falls. We drove into a parking place right in front of the Pine Hotel. And here these two beautiful girls come walking down the street. And we asked them if they wanted to go for a ride. They said, sure. I jumped out of the car and held open the back door. Well, thank goodness she crawled in the back seat. And I want to tell you kids, my kids, what the hell is that other woman that crawled in the back seat? You wouldn't have been here. You wouldn't have been here, would you?
No, wait a minute.
I had pressure on being a father.
That's really something to think about, because all you grandkids and the whole thing would not have been here if that other woman had been... girl in the back seat.
Who was she?
How'd you guys pick?
That what?
How'd you pick? You didn't pick. She
didn't.
She grabbed
his dough
in the back seat.
I just opened up the door and walked around to the back and opened the door. The other woman got in the front seat with Kenneth Drury. You remember Clyde? You remember Kenneth Drury?
What color hair is he at?
Yeah.
And your grandma called.
His grandma likes blue eyes.
See, that's how I met her.
Yeah.
And that's
well,
you too.
I just say that, Dana, because I'm so mad at
him. Well, you shouldn't be mad. He did the right thing.
All right.
Oh, sure. Then jerk it out of my hand. Come here, mother. Four children that were somewhat. Well, somewhat. I'll say that. We have a beautiful lady right here on my right. She was a valedictorian of Holmdel High School. Christ, she won't let me forget that.
How many graduated?
12. How many graduated? Yeah, 12. No, she really was. And she ran around a lot and she drank. Oh, wait a minute. No, you didn't. No. I'm sorry.
What was that?
Wrong sister.
We don't want to do that.
Sister.
No, cut that. Cut that, girl. Cut that off. No. But she did. You know, she used to jump off of the Holmdel Bridge.
All right, Mom.
Yeah, she did.
Skinny dippy.
No kidding.
Water skin.
No, she really did. And she was valedictorian. And there was a lot of other things. But Denny's here now. So I don't want to go into that. Okay?
I know more about it than you do, Bill.
Oh, don't do that. Three, we got to pay five. I said, well, the hell, that's a deal. Just let me out. Well, about the fourth time I was in the movies, I realized she was kidding. Because I spent the night in the trunk.
Oh,
I really did. No, she was a good girl. She really was. never mind. But you know, you laugh. You went in the movies. You were really good. Great. Yeah. Gidget Goes Away. You know this girl right here? Elvis Presley.
Late
show. Yeah.
It was her leg.
No, really. She was in the movie with Elvis Presley. She was in the movie with that guy that with the frog suit on and the big fins. What's his name?
Lloyd Bridges.
Lloyd Bridges, yeah. I'll never forget him. Yeah.
You did.
Well, I did, yeah. But anyway, yeah, you did that. Karen just kind of just drifted off and did her thing. But Karen had a funny way about her. She had all the animals. She had dogs. She had horses. She had cats. And I'm the only son, right? Now, I should have a dog. Am I correct? I mean the son, right? I'm out here with a shotgun, and I should have a son, right? Or a dog, excuse me. So where's that? Well, it's mine. Well, I'd go out and sprinkle a little corn and, you know, seeds. Well, whose chicken's that? Well, it's mine. You know, what the hell? I got one, too. And then they come home from college and say, Jesus Christ, what a flock. No, and she had seven dogs. I mean, I'm the son, right? Aren't sons supposed to have dogs? Huh? Dad, I'm talking to you, buddy. I'm serious. God damn. A girl's bicycle and a chicken? Come on. Remember those days, Penny? Oh, come on. Penny used to remember those. She lived in Holmdel. She used to laugh at me when I went by. Oh, there's a little kid in a pink bike and a chicken. No, don't laugh. It's not funny. But really, but Karen saved me one time. She really did. I got bit by it. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. We have something to say about the cameraman. One afternoon, I was strolling along on my pink girl's bicycle.
Now there, I'll go along with
that. And my chicken.
No, leave that out.
Chicken. was running right alongside of me. And Kelly Maccabee, I'll never forget the name, because that was the guy who paid me. I threw the paper, his dog ran and jumped over the fence, killed my chicken, and come over and bit me on the side of the leg. No, it wasn't. Because when I fell down, Dad happened to just kind of see me fall down, because I was close to home, into my route, you know, one of those kind of deals, you know. So he said, Jesus, your leg is, what happened? I said, the Maccabee dog bit me. So he runs me down to George Wolf. Dr. George Wolf. He knows everything, right? Sure. We walk in there, and June, his nurse at that time, says, what's the matter? Well, hell, I'm bleeding. I don't need a nurse to say, what's the matter? So then George comes out. He says, what's the matter? Dad says, big chested dad, you know how he is. Well, my son got bit with a dog. Well, whose dog was it? Well, it was Maccabee's. Well, put him on the table. So I went in and on the table, right? They thought I had rabies.
They were right.
Yeah. So anyway, you want to take another drink? Anyway, I got 12 shots, no kidding, in my big toe, and I'm fine. But I'll tell you what, these people are fun, aren't they? You ready?
Don't you worry. I want to tell you why my brother only had a chicken and didn't have a dog, okay? Are you ready for this? My dad didn't like dogs. Poor daddy. Really had a thing about dogs. We had one when we were a kid. This was before Billy was born. He followed my father everywhere. But my father, being the good guy that he is, told George and Trix that he would come over and take care of their place for them while they were off on one of their trips to Canada. This is a true story. They were off visiting, and Daddy said, yeah, I'll come over every day. I'll water your plants, feed your animals, do all of the good things that need to be done. But this darn dog that we had followed my father everywhere he went. So my dad goes over, Mom's in the kitchen, watering the plants, dusting, doing all the nice things for George and Trix that they were supposed to do. And out in the back, Penny had her little pet rabbit cage. We knew that. And they were supposed to go out and take care of the rabbit and all those things. So they were just getting ready to go out in the backyard. They looked over, the cage was empty. They looked around the corner, came this stupid dog that we had with Penny's pet rabbit in its mouth, just shaking the heck out of that thing, killed it, dead. My dad said, oh my gosh, what are we gonna do? The dog has eaten the rabbit. We can't tell George and Trix that. They'll never let us have anything to do with them again. They're gonna be so mad, Penny's gonna cry, what are we gonna do? My dad was so mad at that dog. Well, my mother, you know how neat my mother is. She said, well, we can't let him know that this happened. So my mother goes out and picks up this stupid, dirty little rabbit, parts of it that's left, you know. She runs in the house and she puts it under the water faucet and got the soap out and the brush and she cleans the stupid dead rabbit all up and blows it dry so that everything's all nice again. Takes it back out and lays it in the cage. They'll never know. They'll never know. So about 2 days later, George and Trix get home. George calls up Dad. Dad says, well, how's everything, George? George says, fine. And Dad said, everything's fine? Yeah, everything's fine. Except, you know, the strangest thing happened. He said, about a day before we went on our vacation, Penny's rabbit died and we buried it. And all of a sudden, it appeared. When my mom and dad got married on October 21st, 1938, they decided to get married at noon And my father had to go to work that afternoon. Can you believe it? He really did this. And they didn't have a lot of money, like a lot of people didn't at those times. So he lived with Clyde in another little house. So they had a room with them. Well, apparently, now, October's pretty darn cold in Twin Falls, anywhere. Remember, you know how cold it can get here. It's nice. It's beautiful now. We couldn't have asked for better weather. But apparently, the Newmans and the Petzolds decided that they would take turns stoking up the coal stove in the middle of the night. So here are the newlyweds on their honeymoon in one room, and my mom was nominated to get up and stoke the stove. Well, she had the presence of mind at least to put a house coat on. This is true. My mother gets up in the middle of the night and goes out to stoke the coal stove, not realizing that the sleeve of that thing was a little bit too big. Anyway, she's stoking around, the doggone sleeve caught on fire. Now, you've got to visualize this. My mother standing in the kitchen with her arm on fire, slowly this fire is spreading all over her body. She starts screaming. Clyde in the other room hears her. My father in the other room hears her. Now, being newlyweds, you got to remember how much my father had on. Clyde probably didn't have much on either. I'm not sure about him. Okay. The screams start, my mother's screaming, Clyde runs for my mother. He gets her, right? Okay, he's throwing her on the ground, trying to put this fire out. My father, being the Lancelot that he is, forgets that he wears glasses. Okay, in the middle of the night, he jumps up, no clothes on, runs for my mother, slams into the door, knocks himself out cold, plop, laying there, naked as a jaybird, flat on his back, knocked out cold, my mother and Clyde rolling around on the kitchen floor. Now you can imagine what and that is true, that actually happened. But that was their wedding night, and I'll tell you, it not many of us have that much excitement in one night. My mother told me that there were a lot of rules for a good marriage, and one of them was to make sure that you wash your husband's hair, which she did for a long time. I always said, Mama, why in the world do you wash your husband's hair? She's wash your husband's hair, you love it. Have long.
That's why it's white.
That's why it's white. Bleached it out. She washed it a lot. She had long fingernails. She said, boy, those long fingernails will come in handy when you scratch their backs. Those men won't want to leave you. And that's true. That's why Karen and I are growing these long fingernails. Cheryl's working on it. But I'll tell you something. It took me a long time to get my husband, and you notice how much I've been washing his hair. He had a lot more when we got married. And if you want, I'll have him stand up and show you the scars on his body. We're working on those scratches. But there's a couple things I wanted to tell you. I got lost my thoughts here. Hold on.
Okay, sweetie. I tell you what. What I want Linda to do right now, sing a little song. Because I think this thing is just going a little too far. And I'm getting too drunk. And boy, I could tell stories about everybody in this room, but I'm not going to. Thank you. I don't know who said that. Oh, you. Okay. You want to hear him insult anybody?
I won't insult
anybody. We've damn near done that.
Our cameraman is getting tired.
I know it. I'm mad.
Is he still awake?
Boy, I'll tell you what. Wearing that tie, he's got to be tired.
Well, I'll tell you why my cleavage keeps showing. It's the only pin I could find to get my mother's corsage on, and I don't have a belt because I had to loan that someone to keep their pants up. But I wanted to tell you the advice that my mother gave me. She said to me, I got to get this just exactly right. Well, you know how much trouble we all have in our family with hearing. And my mother said to me, and you know, we don't always get things right, right? My mother said to me, I just wish for you that all of you could be married 50 years. And I thought, what a nice thing. But I thought she said, I wish all of you would get married 50 times. So we tried. But anyway, I just want you to know that there sits a pair of parents that have never embarrassed me in my life, and not many people can say that. I had the prettiest mother, the neatest mother, the nicest father. Whenever there was a party to go on or something, you know, it was always, let's go to Linda's house, because at Linda's house, we know we'll have a fair party, you know, that's not a father that's going to go out and beat everybody up, and a mother that's going to understand because she knew what it was like to be young. And I'll tell you one thing, when Clyde and Francie got married, my mom and dad left town. So all of the kids in Homedale said, hooray, a party, we'll all go over to Petzl's house and have a party. You know what it was like when you were 18 years old. So here they all come back from Clyde and Francie's wedding, and we had had a party. Some kids had run over the rose bushes, and they had broken the lights. Colleen Palmy, being a nice, sweet, oh, she was here tonight, had gone into the bathroom, and she decided she was going to fix these prize rose bushes that my mother and dad had out in the front yard. They didn't have much of a yard, but they had prize rose bushes. She went into the bathroom and got a bunch of Kotex and wrapped it all around all the branches of the trees and fixed those little babies up so they weren't broken anymore. So here they come back, and here are these rose bushes all done up in white with wrappings all around, and they just laughed. Sure they did. Well, anyway, I'm very, very proud, and they always seem to understand everything that went on in our lives, and I don't know why. They're very, very patient people. I did get a song together for them, and I get nervous, and so when I'm nervous, I don't always remember things, so you'll be patient when I have my... Yeah, but this...
Hang on just a sec.
Well, I'm doing it.
No, you're not. You're not doing it right. I'll teach you.
We just love Mom and Dad so much, and we're so proud of them to be here tonight. Are you?
Are you?
No. Mom and Dad, I do love you, but... It just bothers me to be up in front of everybody. It does, and I wish I could be more like Linda and Billy. But I love them just the same.
Don't wish that.
Well, if you were like me, you wouldn't be as pretty. You would be real ugly.
I do love you, Mom and Dad.
Well. We're going to have Linda sing her song. And if they were going to take you people, and we're just going to wine and dine you, whatever you want to do. But we do want Linda to sing a song. She has a beautiful voice, and we would like to have you hear this. Okay. This is for Mom and Dad.
I might have to stop this because I don't know how loud it is. I have no idea what's going on with this. Okay.
You ready? Take a deep breath, baby.
Look the other way, Mom. You'll cry.
I took my shoes off.
My family through.
Yeah, we're going to let them cut the cake right now. So if everybody be seated, we'll let them cut the cake. We'll take a few pictures. And then, you know what we can do? Party down.
There's a little light at the bottom.
Yeah?
It's on.
Okay.
You see the light come on down there.
Yeah.
And you can, and you take a picture of the cake, you see?
Okay.
Yeah.
that's not taking a picture now.
Why?
Because there's no light at the bottom. There's a little
light at the bottom is on.
No, it isn't.